The Fundamental Theorem of Arithmetic says, any integer greater than 1 has a unique prime factorization. Here's the proof. We will use proof by contradiction. For the first part, we will assume that it is not true. So that would mean that there exists an integer that is not the product of primes. So, because of that assumption, we are able to say that the set that contains integers greater than 1 that do not have prime factors is nonempty. Now, because of the well-ordering principle, we are able to say that there exists a least element in the set. We will call this element n. Now, because n divides itself and n has no prime factors, then this implies that n itself cannot be prime. Because n is not prime and has no prime factors, then that means it is the product of two composite integers. We will say that these two integers are a and b, and because n itself is not prime, then that would mean that both a and b have to be greater than 1 and less than n. Now, because a is less than n, and we know that n is the smallest positive integer greater than 1 that cannot be written as the product of primes, then that would mean that a itself would have to be the product of primes. We will say that a equals an arbitrary product of primes, where at least one of the degrees of the primes is non-zero. Now we know that a is the product of primes, we can sub it back into the equation, and we see that n itself also has a prime factor. Therefore, any integer greater than 1 can be written as the product of primes. Now to prove that each prime factorization is unique, we will assume that there exists a number n that has two distinct prime factorizations. Now we can say that a set that contains integers greater than 1 that don't have unique prime factorizations is nonempty. So again, by the well-ordering principle, we can say that there is a least element of this set. We will call it n. We will say that n has two distinct prime factorizations. Next, we can say that p1 divides one of the prime numbers qj. However, this is arbitrary, so we will say divides q1. This follows from Euclid's lemma. Next, because p1 divides q1 and both are prime, this implies that p1 equals q1. p1 equals q1 implies that there is another integer that has two distinct prime factorizations. However, this integer has to be less than n, which implies that n is not the least element of this set. This is a contradiction which implies that each prime factorization is unique.